Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Ray and I'll be studying Physical and Natural Sciences at the University of Cambridge from next month. And as you can expect from the title, I got an ASR and A-level chemistry, so I'll be going through how. So this advice is applicable to all other exam boards, but just for context, I did OCR A chemistry. I'll be going through all the resources I used and how I use them one by one, whilst giving any examples where necessary. A link to any other websites I used will be in the description. So firstly, download your specification and then either print it out or upload it to somewhere like OneNote so you can annotate it as you're going along. I made sure that I checked off anything that I covered and highlighted anything that I thought I hadn't covered, and then either went to a textbook or some other online resource and made sure I knew that, because you don't want to be in the exam situation and realize you don't know something because you hadn't made sure using the specification. I would recommend, if you don't understand any of the wording, go to your teachers and ask them for any clarification, because they're the ones whose job it is to know inside out, so they should be able to help you there. So secondly, the most important thing I did was use flashcards. So I made my flashcards on a computer on a Word document that had a table with two columns, the first being for the questions and the second being for the answers. The reason I used a computer was because it makes everything so much easier. So you can just Google and find images of mechanisms and reactions and equations which you need, and if you find a mistake you can just easily edit it and you don't feel a temptation to make your flashcards look nice, so you'll spend more time learning than actually making the flashcards look neat and everything. So after making the flashcards, I transfer them over to an app called Anki by copying and pasting the question and the answer separately for each of the cards. And the reason I used Anki was because it has this thing called spaced repetition. So when you're doing the card, when you're doing each flashcard, then you can either decide if the answer was easy for you to remember or if it was harder for you to remember. So then based on that, it decides when you will see the flashcard again. So the easy flashcards will come up less frequently and the harder ones will come up more frequently. So it kind of decides your revision for you. You spend more time revising the things you find harder and less time revising the things you find easier over time. And then just before topic tests or exams, I would go through all the flashcards in that particular topic. If you don't know how to use Anki, I'd highly suggest finding some videos online on how to use it, because a small amount of time you spend in learning how to use it will pay off massively in the long run. Since I've been using it for the last 3 years or so, I'll get around to making a guide, like a complete guide on how to use Anki, and it should either be linked up somewhere if it's out by now. I'd highly suggest making your own flashcards, because at least 50% of the learning comes from making them and the other percentage comes from going through them. So the best part about using Anki is that you can be as strict as you want. So for definitions, you can say, if I don't get this definition word for word, then I'm going to mark it as wrong. And for concepts, you can give yourself some leeway with the wording. So it's really versatile and for you to decide. But I would suggest when you're going through the flashcards, you verbalize your answers. So when you come across a question, you quietly speak the answer to yourself, because it'll stop you from tricking yourself into thinking you knew the answer if you're saying in your head. But the most important thing to remember when doing the flashcards is the more effort you put into remembering the answer, the easier it'll get over time. So while initially it can be quite hard and you feel tempted to flip over to the other side and pretend as though you've got it right, the more effort you put into remembering, the stronger your synapse connections will be. So now I'll move on to what I use to help me actually make the flashcards, because that's also very important. So the first thing I used to help me make my flashcards were my class notes. every weekend, what I do is go through all my class notes for that week and turn them into flashcards. And that they were like the backbone, bare-bone flashcards on which I'd add to using other resources just to make sure they're as good as possible before I start learning them. So the second resource I used to help me make them was ChemGuide. I personally thought ChemGuide went a bit too into detail, and I only used it for about a few dozen topics just to make sure I really understood what was going on in those topics and I could write it into my own words onto the flashcards. But I wouldn't suggest going on every page for the whole syllabus, because you're only going to find small areas of ChemGuide useful. So then I used a website called ChemRevise, and ChemRevise has really good notes for OCR, AQA, EdExcel. I think they have every exam board for chemistry, and I used those notes to make sure my class notes were detailed and comprehensive enough, and then I used them to add onto the flashcards, and any mechanisms or diagrams or equations which I thought were good, I just copy them over or take a screenshot and get them over onto my flashcards just to make them a bit more detailed. So the next resource I used was YouTube, and the YouTubers you'd use for chemistry really depends on the exam board you're doing, but you have some YouTubers like Allery Chemistry who've made playlists for EdExcel, AQA, OCR. But for me, I used a YouTuber called MyChemGuy and Allery Chemistry. I thought MyChemGuy was better because it was more tailored towards OCR chemistry. When using them, I watched all their videos on each of the topics and made sure I had a clear understanding of what was going on. And then I explained the ideas in my own words and added them all onto the flashcards. So this really helped me understand more, and it made my flashcards a lot better than just actually using written documents, because I don't know about you, but I learned best using videos. Just quickly googling should help you find any other YouTubers which are for your exam boards. I know there are some for AQA and EdExcel out there as well. It is quite clear to see at this point my flashcards essentially became my class notes. So the next resource is Physics and Maths Tutor. While I think the website is a bit overrated, it does have a good collection of questions for each topic. So any topics you're struggling with, you can just find old specification questions on there to help with your learning for year 12 and year 13. It also has a good collection of past papers, the old spec ones, which are harder to find at other places. But you can also find them for OCR at least on a website called Past Paper Panda. I'll be moving on to how I used past papers later on. So the next really important thing for my chemistry revision was organic pathways. This becomes so much more important towards the end of year 13, because by then you will have covered a lot of reactions. And I would suggest finding a template for the organic pathways, which you need to know, and then doing them every day. So learning it, and then trying to write in as much from memory every day for about 2 months before the exam, or 3 months if you want to start sooner. And just keep doing every day and it'll eventually go in. And if you're doing past papers alongside that, you can easily identify which ones you need to work on the most, which reactions you need to work on the most. And finally, perhaps the most important thing on this list is doing past papers. I don't think anyone's gotten a good grade in chemistry without doing at least some past papers. As for me, I did every single one and I kept track of them on Excel. And as you can see here, I had green, amber and red. Green for being above 90%, amber for being about 80%, and red for being 70% or less. I would suggest when doing the papers, be strict on timing, because you don't want to give yourself the illusion of you have more time yet than you actually do, because that will come back and bite you during the exam. There's also no point in doing the past papers if you're not going to actually learn from your mistakes, because you'll just end up repeating them over and over. I would suggest after each paper, you add to a Word document of your mistake and how it can be corrected or how it can be avoided in some way. And read this document several times a week closer to your exams just to make sure you really know what mistakes to look out for. It's really helpful if you have a whole list of common mistakes which you make in chemistry. It will vary from person to person, but the document will become very, very useful. I would suggest doing past papers consistently, especially doing more as you get closer to exam time. So rather than doing a free on a Saturday, you can do free throughout the week. But when you do so, make sure that you mark it then and there, because you don't want past papers piling up. And when you sit down and mock a past paper you did a few days earlier, mock an answer wrong and not being sure why you thought that during the time. And also pay close attention to any keywords from the mark schemes when you're marking your papers, and then change your flashcards on that bit of the specification accordingly, so you end up learning the keywords as part of your revision. If you get confused with any of the questions, either search the paper on YouTube and you can watch a teacher going through it and explaining each question one by one, or go to your actual teacher and have them explain it and make sure you absolutely understand where you went wrong and how you went wrong, because otherwise you're just going to keep making the same mistakes. And of course, you can add to your document after speaking to your teacher and watching a video. So I hope this video was useful, and good luck with any exams you have in chemistry. It can be a hard subject, but as long as you're willing to put in the time and effort, it can also be very rewarding. So I made some other How to Get an A Star videos for physics and maths and further maths, and if you want to check them out, they should be linked down below or at the end of this video. If you have any suggestions for any videos I should make, like exam technique and avoiding silly mistakes and stuff like that, then leave a comment down below. And leave a like and subscribe to my channel for any more videos of studying and university.